Hello and good morning, friends. Today I want to talk to you about how is a dry well constructed, what do they look like, what do they do, when will you find them, and how do they work for your system today. Let's get into it. So, dry wells, what are they? Basically, the best thing to think about for a dry well is that it's just a really big pit in the ground that dissipates the water into the soil, right? It's part of the absorption system for your septic tank. Every septic system will have at minimum two parts, right? You're gonna have the tank itself and the absorption system. The tank is gonna capture the solids and the absorption system is gonna deal with the liquids because you have to get rid of the water somehow. If you introduce 10 gallons of water into the system, you have to get rid of the 10 gallons of water. Otherwise, you're gonna run the water right back into the house, right? Nobody wants that. So in our area, generally you would see dry wells between the years of 1950 to mid 1980s. And the reason why is in the 80s, everybody switched to drain fields. Drain fields are way easier to construct, way cheaper, way safer, less headaches go involved into them. So everybody used to drain fields. There are still some dry wells that are used, but more commonly in our area, dry wells are now gonna be used more for rainwater runoff, right? So they're just gonna be a big pit in the ground. Nowadays, those pits are gonna be filled with stone. But back in the day, how they were built was it'd just be a giant void. So generally, they'll be an 8 to 10 foot diameter, right? They'll be dry stacked cinder block and stone on the exterior. Usually, they would use like small little river rock, or they would use number two limestone back in the day. But the reason that they would dry stack the cinder block is so that way, as the water from the tank goes into the pit, cinder block is inherently porous, right? And as the water goes in, it'll seep through the cinder block and then it'll actually go through the separations in the block itself. The stone is just there to open the soil up and allow for the water to move into the ground, right? The ground is actually what's going to be solving the issue of the drainage. That's going to be your filtering media, right? So as the water goes in, it's going to have all sorts of bacteria, particulates, all sorts of things that you don't really want getting out, right? So that debris gets stuck in the soil, and as the water goes through that soil, it'll fall down into the aquifer, and then eventually, you know, nature's cycle repeats itself, right? So dry wells would be having that cinder block walls, but they would also put a nice solid 4-inch thick lid right on top, and that would just be concrete, right? A lot of times that would be formed on site. Sometimes they're made off site and brought in. It just depends on how they installed it. From there, they would have the little plug to put a 6-inch clean out onto it. And the reason that they would put that clean out in there is so that way you could see where the water level in the pit is. And the reason why that's important is as those pits age, just like with drain fields, a little bit of biomat, which is debris, biologic material, will work its way from the tank and into the pit. As that debris works its way into the pit, it's kind of like tar. It's real sticky and it's non-permeable. So what'll happen is it'll line the soil on the outside of that stone and not allow the water to escape. And over time, that water will basically fill up and fill up and fill up until eventually it's got nowhere to go but back to the tank. And once it starts doing that, that's called a backup. In our area, once a dry well's basically filled up completely, you only got really two options. The most common option is to basically replace it. But the second least common option, which is kind of like a Band-Aid, it doesn't really permanently solve the situation, is you pump it and you can use an enzyme treatment to help to dissolve some of that biomat. It's very uncommon and it's not considered by the state as a proper repair to a septic system. It must be noted if you're going to do that, you have to pull a permit to disclose that the system had failed and that you attempted that solution. And the reason why is so that way you can let everybody know, like, hey, this is what's going on. Why is that important, you might ask? Well, let's just say that you are building a pool, and sometimes the counties will make you actually do an inspection to make sure that they know where all your septic pieces are. You're building a pool, that inspection happens, and you find out that the pit is not good, right? Well, now you have to disclose to the county that the pit's not good while you're doing the drain or doing the pool permit, and then when you're doing the pool permit, now you have to pull the permit to replace the pit. Well, let's just say that you don't have $15,000 because you put all that money into the pool. All right, that's fair. That's a valid issue. So now you can pull the permit to say, hey, we know that this dry well failed. We're going to pump it down and we're going to try this solution. Maybe it's $900. Maybe it's $1,000. Who knows what it's going to be, right? But we know that this is a problem. We're permitting it. We're doing everything correctly. We're good to go. Now, let's just say you didn't do that. That's where it can get into a little bit of complications as far as property transfer and legalities go, right? So if it has failed in the past, and you know that it has failed, now that's a latent defect that you have to disclose to whoever you decide to sell the property to. If you hold onto the house for the next 30 years, it doesn't matter, right? But this really only kind of matters if you know that you're going to sell it in the next 5-10 years and that thing failed, right? So you have to disclose it. It's also very important to have that as a permit for whoever's working on that septic system, so that way they know, like, hey, this is broken in the past, so that way they can kind of figure out exactly how they want to go about mitigating any issues that arise in the future, all right? So pits are not super common anymore. The main safety concern with these pits is those walls are made of cinder block. Cinder block, like I said, is porous. Well, I don't know if you've ever taken a hammer and smacked a cinder block, but it's pretty soft. Like, if it's wet, it will crumble, right? And where a lot of people run into issues is if they put excessive amounts of weight, like a larger tractor, a small vehicle, or a large trailer on top of that pit, you can go through the lid and that will crush the entire thing. I had a client a few months back where they were installing a pool, big old 80,000 pound crane, got a little bit too close with one of the tires, and the whole thing went into the pit. All right. Now, the crane operator should not have been as close to that pit as he was, but that can happen regularly. People have fallen into these pits, have gotten seriously hurt, and they have gotten injured. And as far as I'm aware, some people have died. I've never personally met anybody who's had that happen, but I have met dozens of people who have fallen into those pits because of collapses. So nowadays with a pit, if that's going to be done, it has to be, that void has to be full of stone or some kind of aggregate. So that way, if that lid does collapse, it's not going to be an 8-foot sinkhole full of sewage water. It'll just be like a small little depression in the grass, right? So let me know below, have you ever had to address your drywall? Do you have a drywall on your house? I always think it's fun to see what people have, what kind of systems you have. Leave a comment below. Tell me what kind of septic system you have on your house, if you have a septic system at all. If you don't have a septic system, tell me where, like, what kind of city are you near? How many people are over there? What's the maintenance like for your public sewer, right? Do you maintenance your public sewer? It's always fun to figure out. I have videos posted every day on the world of well and septic. If you enjoy content like this, please hit that like button, hit subscribe. And if there's a particular topic or an area of conversation you'd like me to cover, please leave a comment below and I try to get to all of them as fast as I can. I'll talk to you guys soon.